views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of the station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
Welcome to Lyme Talk Radio with Dr. Pat Baccili, epic healing for an epic life. This inspiring show highlights leading-edge solutions, groundbreaking research, headline topics, and tools for holistic healing and wellness. This hit show is dedicated to raising awareness, promoting advocacy and prevention, and supporting initiatives for optimal health. Dr. Pat is passionate and focused on life-saving results reaching far beyond Lyme disease, providing a forum for powerful stories, heart-opening experiences, and hope-activated solutions. Dr. Pat will shine a light on the many shades of Lyme disease, fueled by a body-mind-spirit remedy. Now here's your host, Dr. Pat.
Boom, everybody. That's what I'm talking about. Boom to all of that. And by the way, I'm sitting here and I'm listening to the show and I'm getting ready for the intro. I'm Dr. Pat. You are listening to Lyme Talk Radio. I'm also the host of the Dr. Pat Show. I'm listening to this and I'm going to go down to this Westerly Community Credit Union myself. I mean, I'm thinking I'm ready to go get myself a house there in Westerly. I'm going to have to call these folks and go down there and go to see what they got going on. I'm just sitting here and I'm listening to it and I'm thinking how blessed we are for the community of Westerly, Rhode Island. How so blessed we are. Not to mention that food that I heard before the intro. Dr. Roni's joining me here today, and I can't even tell her about what I'm thinking about right now, because if I were in Westerly, Rhode Island right now, I would be going getting that salami. I would be right there. Dr. Roni DeLuz is joining me here today. Naturopathic doctor is an understatement for how I describe who she is and what she does. You know, she and I have gotten to share the stage, let's just call it, over these past bunch of years several times. And you could tell that when we are together, we're together at these events, whether we're there looking at Lyme disease or if we're there and we're looking at, you know, people's support of cancer awareness or holistic solutions to living, or whether you know Dr. Roni for a fabulous hit show and you want to understand the importance of detox in your body, whether it's 21 pounds in 21 days or simply wanting to live the best life you can. This is a woman that doesn't even understand why the word no is actually in the English language. And the reason I say that is because she and I have had so many people that have come up in our lives telling us you can't do this, you're not going to be successful at this, people can't even spell the word holistic, why bother? But let's fast forward to today. Not only is Dr. Roni DeLuz passionate, not only is she miraculous, but, you know, miracles of holistic health and wellness. Her radio show reaches people all over the world. But what? We can find her in your own backyard. So for those of you folks in Westerly, Rhode Island, and you're thinking, how can I find Dr. Roni? She's right up the road for you. If you're thinking, I know somebody that is not feeling really well, I know a family that maybe has Lyme disease, I'm worried about my own condition, Dr. Roni is a stone's throw away. And this is why we do what we do. Because today we get to talk about how to feel better so you can get better. Now, when we're talking about natural medicine, we're talking about nutrition, we're talking about some things that are so basic, so simple in their essence, but so difficult, especially when you have a chronic disease. Dr. Roni, welcome to the show. It's great to have you here.
Hello, Dr. Pat. It's my pleasure to be here always. It was very exciting to know that I was going to do this show with you. Every time I do a show with you, I'm excited because I know you get it, and I know your passion is just like mine, is we want to change a lot of lives in the world. I've been doing this for over 30 years, and I look at the world and I say, you know what? It's a better place. We're living in a better We have so much knowledge available to us because of the internet. But at the same time, we still have a lot of chronic diseases creeping up, and we have a very long way to go. Now, one of the things why I wanted to talk about Lyme disease today and how you have to feel better first in order to get better. That is so profound, because at the retreat, I specialize in 21 chronic illnesses. I've been dealing with chronic illness since the time I was very young, working at Yale New Haven Hospital as a registered nurse. I used to deal with some of the most complicated chronic illnesses in the country, because and out of the country, because they used to ship rare syndromes into Yale New Haven Hospital. So I got the opportunity to learn a lot about how the body works and how to deal with some of the most serious whole body diseases. Now, talking about that, one of the things that I realized about Lyme and being and living in Massachusetts, which is a high, very high incidence of Lyme's, one of the things that I learned living here and watching these clients, I started saying, you know, there's this reminds me of fibromyalgia, reminds me of environmental illness, it reminds me of lupus, it reminds me of multiple sclerosis, it reminds me of some of the most complex whole body diseases. So I says there was a aha moment, and that aha moment was, you have to deal with Lyme the same way you deal with a lot of whole body diseases and chronic illnesses. You got to deal with it like the whole body. And what I want, and what I was trying to say, is that there are reasons why curing chronic Lyme is so complicated with a lot of medical doctors. And the reason why it's so complicated is because we're dealing with so many different we're dealing with immune system that's being compromised. We're dealing with the body being in a chronic state of inflammation. I mean, it's sad what I see when they walk through the doors of the retreat. I can clearly see that they're having focus and memory problems. I can clearly see that they can't eat anything at this point. I mean, we talk about being gluten-free, and we talk about decreasing our sugar content, but they're at the point now where even good, healthy foods that we consider good and healthy, they can't eat that. So now we're talking about their GI tract is lacking in a lot of probiotics. And then we find out, after doing a lot of blood tests, because we do a lot of blood tests at the retreat now, we do integral wellness blood work. So now we find out that they're lacking in they have major nutritional deficiencies. And I'm not even finished. I think I'm only up to six. And I can go on and on and on with maybe five or eight more different reasons why chronic Lyme is so complicated to maintain or cure or to get under control, for lack of better words. But at the same time, on this show today, I want to leave the listeners with something so basic that they can do today, right now, to make themselves feel better so that they can at least get out of bed and get on the track of trying to find the right help, whether that is finding the Lyme literate doctor or whether that's getting in your car, traveling far to find that doctor. You have to do what you have to do to get better, but you have to start with, what do I do to first feel better? Does that make sense?
Yeah. Yeah, it does make sense, because nobody really does. I don't know where people go, but, I was just at the doctor's myself yesterday, and nobody asked me anything about feeling better, right? Nobody asked me, they didn't even ask me how I felt, period.
Right.
Now, what is wrong with that picture? If you're going in to get a procedure or whatever it is you're getting done, maybe you have insurance, maybe you don't. But if you have insurance, your insurance is going to pay a lot of money for it. And nobody asks you how you're feeling. There's something odd about that to me.
Because
but that's really the state of affairs, Roni, isn't it?
It is. It's sad, because how you're feeling is too complex for them to work on. What they really want to know is, they want to narrow down to a symptom so that they can give you a medication for that symptom. But see, that is the beginning of what I call that medicine wheel. You know, you get on track with the medicine wheel, you start with one medication and you end up having another. You know, the last Lyme client that I had here was on 9 different medications. And, and I said, well, no wonder you don't feel good. And I asked her, I said, so what is this one for? She didn't. I said, well, at least you could tell me. You know, the assessment, first of all, took us like 4 hours. We had to take a break. And so before I got through the assessment, because her mental, her brain fog was so high that I couldn't even get through the assessment. So she didn't know why she was on 9 different medications. She forgot. She knew 2 of them were antibiotics and 1 of them was for her cholesterol, but the rest, forget it. Mm-hmm. And the reason, it's not her fault. The reason why she didn't know is because she don't feel good. And if you don't feel good, you can't possibly help yourself get well.
Yeah. Well, I mean, not only that, your experience and all of that, but you're somebody as well that found, you were the founder and are the founder of the Martha's Vineyard Holistic Retreat and Wellness Spa. I mean, and so you get people that come through there chronically ill. And I would say this, Roni, maybe you can talk about this. Unfortunately, so, as was in my case, you get the people that come through when they're really almost at the bottom, the end of their rope, so to speak. Nobody else can help them. They don't know where else to go. It's not like, I want a little preventative. Let me call Dr. Roni, although we'd be a whole lot better if we did. So the people you get to see are the people that most of the time the conventional wisdom or medicine of the world would look at and say, we've done all about what we can do.
And that's true. And guess what? I call that stage 4 and sometimes stage 5, no matter what chronic illness. They come at stage 4, stage 5. And I'll tell you, when we get back from break, we have a very high success rate, and it's not complicated. And I'll tell you exactly why we have a successful rate for helping people when we get
back. That's right. And that it's a part of what Dr. Roni does. But beyond all of that, it's knowing that we do not have a one-size-fits-all to anything.
That's
and
right.
What is it that Dr. Roni and her team does to make sure she's not pulling this thing off the shelf like you would a can of tomatoes? Let's take a short break. We'll be right back.
Transformation Talk Radio is dedicated to the education and awareness of Lyme disease.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to Lyme Talk Radio. I'm Dr. Pat, joined here by
Dr. Nusheen Darvish.
Dr. Pat Baccili and Dr. Nusheen Darvish will be bringing the most innovative, groundbreaking information, research, treatment innovations, and stories from those it affects every day.
I'm so excited to be talking about this.
We have so much to share.
Dr. Darvish and I are planning to do is connect the dots.
People suffering with all sorts of chronic diseases, it's time. It is time for them to transform.
Tune into Lyme Talk Radio and help keep our mission strong.
For the loyal listeners out there that have been listening to this incredible show on Lyme disease, we are not going to let you down. We're going to come through stronger and enrich the platform for Lyme disease awareness through Lyme Talk Radio. The message will continue. The conversations will become stronger and the healing epic.
Feeling broken from your relationships? Are you second-guessing yourself about friends, family, and lovers? Tune into the hit show that's creating a buzz in the love-seeking community. Love Seeker Radio, finding love for your authentic self with renowned love coach Heather Lynn. Tired of dissatisfying relationships? Kiss them goodbye and power up your love seeker energy. Coach Heather Lynn reminds you that you can just be you, the beautiful and perfect you. Visit heatherlynncoaching.com to learn.
Tune in to the Jen Royster Show, intuitive guidance to inspire your life, each Thursday at 8 a.m. Pacific and 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This amazing show is an inspirational hour that will take you on an epic metaphysical journey to discover the spiritual approach to life's greatest challenges. Dr. Jen is an internationally known intuitive counselor, spiritual teacher, and energy healer. Call in for intuitive readings and visit JenRoyster.com for more information.
Enlightening, humorous, and compassionate. Listen live to The Kelly Ballard Show, insight and inspiration from the great beyond. Kelly is a fourth-generation medium and intuitive who covers topics ranging from grief, spirit guides, and listening to your intuition. Kelly can help you get answers and guidance from the other side with a little bit of humor and a lot of healing. Tune in to The Kelly Ballard Show Thursdays at 1 p.m. Pacific Time here on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
1230 WBLQ.
Everybody, welcome back. Dr. Roni DeLuz joining me here today. Roni, before we jump into this conversation, because it's a big one, what is the best way for people to find out more about you?
Well, go to drroniholistichealth.com. That's our newest website. We have so many. We're trying to join them all now. Mm-hmm. You know, you're busy that I'm not a technical person. I'm a healer. And so I forget about all that stuff. And then we have the really, truly. And we get, and then the people say, well, you should have told me. And then we have the MV Holistic Retreat site, and that's where you can go to if you want to come to the retreat. And I won't tell you about the other sites because we're joining them. But that's how you find out a little bit about me and about the work that I do. And the 21 chronic illnesses is one of the things that I've been working on in the last 5 years because I'm writing a new book on that. And I think I can add a lot of value to people's lives. Mm-hmm. The book, my first book, 21 Pounds in 21 Days, made the New York Times bestseller, was the beginning of that era where people started learning a lot about how you keep your body clean. So now that we already know how to keep our body clean and how important that is, we now have to run into what's called let's control our bodies with chronic illness and let's get well.
Well, I mean, one of the things we're looking at here is how do you reverse a lifetime of putting things in your body that you didn't even know you put in. I mean, this would be the interesting conversation if you actually knew everything that you, over time that was going into your body, whether it's the box you pulled off the shelf or the thing that you decided you're going to drink, whatever that is. If we actually knew what we are now learning today, we'd probably think again before we fed our children some of this, right, Dr. Roni? But that's now we're getting smarter.
You know, we are getting smarter, and I think one of the statements that I always make is getting sick is harder than staying well. And so one of the things that, you know, people often ask is that, you know, how do I put in my day all the things that I do? And I says, because what I put in my body is life. If you just think about that one thing, if you put life in your body, you will feel alive. And if you feel alive, you'll feel better. And if you feel better, you'll be able to do all the things you need to do in the day. Now, that's a very basic way of saying you must first learn what to put inside your body in order to feel alive and to feel well. And those things have to be foods that are made or created for life, not dead foods. If you just remember, food that's dead have no vitality, no nutrients in it. Food that is alive have lots of enzymes and lots of nutrients in it. And as you and I are speaking today, you know, there's companies now that are infusing vitamins and nutrients and omega-3s and probiotics in the food. I mean, as sad as that may sound, we're now living in an era where we now have to infuse these things back into our food. And so a lot of us are living on what's called borderline malnutrition. And because of that, you know, we don't go to our doctors and they don't test for things like that. Okay, now they know that, you know, half the population have low vitamin D, so now they're testing for vitamin D. But we have over 43 nutrients that need to be tested for. We're not just vitamin D. There's a lot of vitamins. Most of my clients that come to the retreat are totally malnourished, and vitamin Bs, and there's a lot of Bs, B complex, you know, so, and they don't know that. But when I start giving them the specific food, this Yevo food, if I give them one cup a day of this special protein that we have at the retreat within 3 days, they think that there's been a miracle performing. They'll say, you know, this is a miracle, Dr. Roni. I've never felt this good in the many in the last 20 years. And I will say there's nothing miracle about nutrition in your body to make yourself feel good. That's one of our rights. And so for me, I always say that's pretty sad that all I have to do is teach people what to put in their bodies and they feel better. And take them off some of those medications that they're on that they don't need to be on. Yeah. They have so many side effects.
Well, I think you were talking about this during the break, right? Because, you know, before we went to break, we were talking about, well, wait a minute. You know, we're looking at, and you're writing a book about, and we're now having conversations about 21 chronic illnesses that surface out there. And, you know, what does Lyme disease, what is the effect Lyme disease had? What's the effect it has had? Well, some people would say, Dr. Roni, little to none. Because it's hard to get anyone to recognize, even with celebrities now like Avril Lavigne and others coming to the forefront and saying it does exist. I did a show last week, and I'm going to mention it again. I'm going to turn it over to you. I live in the state of Washington. The state of Washington says we have zero Lyme disease cases. And by the way, the ones that we do have, people got them in other states. So what they're saying is the tick does not come here. You know, in a climate in Western Washington that doesn't necessarily drop below freezing, in a climate where all you have to do is go to Port Townsend and the deer will eat out of your hand. But I just want to say, it doesn't live in the state of Washington or Oregon or California. Now, what do you think about the state of affairs around folks acknowledging that this is a complicated disease, but we do have a solution at some level, right?
Absolutely. And unfortunately, again, it's whole body treatments. Lyme disease now is almost everywhere. You know, we know that. And we had one of the meetings in about 3-4 weeks ago. They're now talking about how they're going to get insurances to take over chronic treatments for Lyme, which is big. I mean, I wouldn't have said this 2 years ago.
Right.
Today, you know, it's growing. And just to say that fact, that means that they're starting to acknowledge that chronic Lyme is everywhere now. So we have made a lot of progress with Lyme, of course. But still, the subject is still talking about how do people recognize the fact that not one particular treatment is going to make them better because it's a whole body disease. And, you know, there's so many different co-infections to Lyme, too, as well. And, you know, one of the things that I talked about before when we did Lyme is that they now are putting Lyme in different classifications just so that the treatment can be specific. The treatment cannot be specific. I mean, even if you have cardiac Lyme or neurological Lyme or GI Lyme or rheumatoid Lyme, I mean, these are all classifications that are being put into a specific classification so that the treatment can zero in on that particular class of symptoms. But still at the same time, the body has the disease all over. It's not just, it's concentrated in that area and that's where your symptoms are, but you have to treat the whole body if you're going to feel better. And so at the retreat, we always start with cleaning the body up and taking you off some of the foods that you eat that makes you feel bad. A lot of people don't realize that their immune system has been compromised to the point where they can't even eat certain foods anymore. So we always start with detoxification and putting in the body maximum nutrition. And when I say maximum nutrition, I'm not talking about giving you a handful of pills. That's what I used to do 25 years ago. But today we don't have to do that. Maximum nutrition comes in the form, as you know, of a green drink, or a very potent antioxidant drink, or a protein smoothie, or a limu juice, or herb. You know, we have so many different herbal elixirs today that's specifically for Lyme and for other chronic illnesses. So if you do these particular types of maximum nutritional drinks throughout the day, you're doing a lot of things for your body. Not only are you cleansing or detoxifying specific organs, but you're also doing what's called immune modulating with some of the phytonutrients that you're taking in. And these phytonutrients today, Dr. Pat, they're so potent that they can get right down to the cellular level. And that's where it needs to go. I mean, many years ago, I've been doing this work for so long. I can specifically remember many years ago, we used to do like a nutrient that would call that expensive urine. Remember that? But we don't talk about it. Urine anymore.
Yeah.
Because we now know that certain nutrients gets right to the cellular level. And that's why, you know, I named the show Miracles of Holistic Health and Wellness, because a lot of these nutrients have the ability to create homeostasis in the body. Now, the other thing that we've done in the last 5 years is we recognize that we have what's called a low level of what's called detoxification phase 1 and 2. So we've been using a lot of glutathione at the retreat.
Yeah.
And glutathione is one of those things that really, really helps the body to detoxify. A lot of people don't even realize that their body struggles with that detoxification part of it. And so we use that. And then we also use high potent vitamin drips. Everyone knows that vitamin C drips are really good for you, but we use a specific type of Myers cocktail that's really good for you. And then when we come back, I'd like to talk a little bit about some of these other modalities that we use at the retreat that really gives your body what's called that kill effect. Because I know that with Lyme, you know, there's people out there listening, okay, well, how do you kill the Lyme? How do you kill the Lyme? You know, we're talking about how to get the body ready to kill the Lyme. You just can't go in there with massive doses of antibiotics and expect the person to be cured. But massive doses of antibiotics sometimes will help you feel better temporarily. However, what did you do to the body after doing that? Are they really cured?
Right. Okay. This is one of the biggest and most controversial conversations. And it has to do with a society that we have, Dr. Roni, that we would trade in a lifetime of wellness for a few moments of feeling better. We do it every day. The question really does become, what do you really want? Would you like to live a life that is healthy, vibrant, and free for a longer period of time? And that's what we're talking about. There's a very good reason why there's the term autoimmune. What does that mean? Do you think maybe if the immune system's attacking itself, that maybe there might be something in there that it's a little bit smarter than we think it is, that there might be something floating around in our bodies that shouldn't be there? Stay tuned. We'll be right back. Dr. Roni's going to talk about how do we get well? What do they do at the Martha's Vineyard Holistic Retreat? What is done there? And we're going to give you some really right out of the gate solutions, things you can do now. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
It's a trip I never wanted to make. Since I've been gone, it just hasn't been the same. And I'm afraid I finally learned how a heart can break. I want you, I need you.
Let the transition begin. Tune in to the hit show, Majestic Insights Radio, Success for Life's Transitions, with host Carrie Keith. Carrie is a gifted intuitive coach, healer, and teacher who will lead you through her empowering techniques of ancient wisdom and awareness so you can live your happiest, healthiest, and most vibrant life. Let Carrie teach you the tools of transformation that will help you experience success for all of life's transitions. To learn more about Carrie, visit www.majesticinsights.com.
How would you like an extra $1,500 in your pocket Black Friday? Central Auto Group, CT.com, your number one buying destination, the home of Ford, Mazda, Hyundai, and Volkswagen, opens at 5 a.m. Black Friday, an annual tradition. From 5 a.m. to 10 a.m. only, when you buy a new vehicle, you get $1,500 to use for whatever you want. How's that for an early holiday gift? Five reasons, one destination, Ford, Mazda, Hyundai, Volkswagen, pre-owned. Drive away a new Ford Focus, Hyundai Accent, or Volkswagen Jetta for $109 a month. and take your pick from the largest selection of Mazdas anywhere. CentralAutoGroupCT.com has $1,500 in free when you buy any new vehicle. But get there early Black Friday starting at 5 a.m. for this incredible deal, because it all ends at 10 a.m. CentralAutoGroupCT.com, exit 28, old exit 87, I-395, Plainfield. See dealer for details.
Your number one buying destination. Central Auto Group.
Hilltop Cafe on the corner of Industrial and Canal wishes you and your family a happy holiday season. Hilltop has $5 pizza, handmade by Pod every Tuesday. Now Hilltop has $18.95 baby back ribs complete with a pint of Budweiser. That's right, $18.95. Wednesday night, November 25th, enjoy the sounds of the Kevin Crandall Band. And Thanksgiving morning, it's an annual tradition. Delicious frittata. Hilltop Cafe on the corner of Industrial and Canal in Westerly.
If you're one of the millions of Americans suffering from anxiety, you probably know how powerless and out of control this emotion can make you feel. This is why it is so important to remember that anxiety is created by your mind, which means that you can learn to use your mind to uncreate it. Hello, my name is Dr. Friedman Schaub. My award-winning book, The Fear and Anxiety Solution, provides you with a step-by-step breakthrough process to understand and resolve the root causes of your anxiety and build a solid foundation of confidence and inner peace. If you're ready to take your power back, visit thefearandanxietysolution.com. That's thefearandanxietysolution.com, or call 866-903-6463. That's 866-903-MIND.
1230 WBLQ.
Everybody, welcome back. Welcome back. It's so great. Thank you for tuning in to Lyme Talk Radio. Dr. Roni DeLuce joining us here. We're going to take you on a journey of what wellness looks like. And Dr. Roni, every show I do, I try to share a little bit of information about Lyme disease and recognize it across the world and recognize it. And just to say, as I was sharing with you during the break, that, you know, our sister country over there, Australia, doesn't even recognize, not the government and not the American Medical Association, the Australian Medical Association, recognize the existence of Lyme disease in Australia. And thank you. Thank you. My hat goes off to a study that is being led by a Perth-based researcher, one step closer to ending Lyme disease debate for good. You know, Peter Irwin is trying to ascertain the bacteria that are making Australians sick. So here's what I want to say. Australians are getting sick with Lyme disease. And they like to say Lyme disease-like symptoms. So let me just be clear there, from local ticks. So Lyme disease-like, disease-like symptoms from local ticks. And thanks for this doctor. Has discovered, Dr. Roni, 70 species of tick in Australia, he said. Ooh. And he goes on to talk about the parallels of the work that's being done overseas. And he's got a very big, great scientific look into the DNA, Lyme disease, identifiable, so forth and so on. OMG, I want to give this man an award for taking this on. Just to say, wait a minute. We are finding a Lyme-type bacteria that's isolated in an Australian vector, like a tick, he said. Wow. What do you want to say to him? Wow. Let's take him out for dinner.
Yes, yes, yes. That's amazing. It's good, good, good. You know, one of the things, you know, I wanted to say is that, you know, we are, remember when we were young and the most favorite part of our day was go outside and play?
Yep.
And today, you know, I have grandkids. So, you know, my little girl, she's two, that little precious grandchild. If my daughter was to send her out and play out inside on the grass and out in the woods and you run around with your bikes and, you know, all of that, we have to worry about them coming back home now with Lyme disease. Mm. So we're not living in a safe world anymore. You know, and I used to get up on TV and radio and write books and say things that, you know, over 1,000 different toxins are dumped into our food supply each and every year. We put hundreds of toxins on our skin for the sake of vanity. You know, we breathe bad air. We live in a toxic building. We work in toxic buildings. And then we ask ourselves, why is our immune system failing us? You know, perhaps what's happening, Dr. Pat, is that we can survive some of these chronic illnesses and tick-borne diseases if our immune system was better. That's what's really failing us. And so when I talk to my Lyme patients on the island, and sometimes I go around the country and talk to them. I visit one lady in Maryland not too long ago, and I was sitting in her on her front porch, and there was a mother deer, father deer, and two little babies. And they didn't run. They just sat there looking at me while I sat on the porch reading my book. And that's the kind of world we live in today. You know, we're living in an environment that's not safe, full of ticks and toxicity. And so we can't no longer cry about that. What we have to really start worrying about is how do we take care of our internal body. Our body houses trillions of cells. And each and every day, we have to protect the internal environment of our body so that we can survive some of these horrific diseases that are going on. And that's really what it amounts to. And so when I'm telling people when they come to the retreat, I have to start with what they put in their bodies. I really have to start with that, because the moment I take away some of the toxic foods that they've been eating, they automatically feel better. And so I will start with that. And then after I remove some of the toxic food that they've been eating on a daily basis, I start giving them food that's what's called food for healing. Food that actually creates change within the body. Food that actually changes and bathes your cellular level to the point where you feel better immediately. It changes the acidity of your body to more alkaline. It changes the way the oxygen in the body is run. It changes the way our vitamins and minerals and everything that we take in is being metabolized at the highest level. That's why people feel better immediately. Within 2-3 days sometimes of being at the retreat, they feel better because of what we're doing, because of what we're actually putting in their bodies. The other thing that what I wanted to tell, and I'm going to leave people with a lot of value today so that when they get off the phone, or when we get off the show and mm-hmm. they get off the phone and get off from listening to us, they can go into their kitchen and they can look in their refrigerator and they can say, okay, this is toxic out, that's toxic out. And then they go to the grocery store, of course, after Thanksgiving, because I know everybody's thinking. So what I would like for people to start putting in their refrigerators, good food that we can actually metabolize, not food that we actually turn to toxicity, because sometimes we are eating food that's not edible. And that's sad to say, but sometimes we eat food that our bodies really don't even know what to do with it. So what it does is dumps it into the trash can, and that's our lymphatic system. It goes into our intestinal tract. It comes out of our intestinal tract sometimes. Sometimes it doesn't, and it leaves us feeling horrible because what we just did was ate some toxic poison. Mm. And that's really what that's all about.
Well, so, you know, Dr. Roni, one of the things that I think you've discovered over time, you know, has to do with the people that come to the retreat center and, you know, what it looks like to actually go there and knowing where to start, because you were so right. It's not as if, is it, Dr. Roni, that we woke up one day, as in my case, I did wake up one day, and by the end of the day, my life was changed. Now, does that mean for me that I had not been building up over decades and decades and decades, you know, metals in my body, heavy metals in my body, or maybe breathing in toxic air, or who knows? I mean, I come from the state of New Jersey, mind you. Yeah, you know, yeah. You can feed those deer out of your hands. Mm. So, you know, part of the conversation is there are layers, aren't there, that have to be peeled back. Layers.
Yes. And there's layers. And, you know, and that, see, one of the reasons why they stay, you know, our retreat is 21 days.
Yeah.
They stay at, is either 21 days, 21 pounds, 21 days, or 21 days, 21 chronic illness. Either way, you're staying 21 days. And that's because of what you just said. The possible, there's this sort of like this map to what happens with us. And it happened to you. I mean, you woke up one day, you felt horrible symptoms, and you said, oh my God, I'm sick. But what led to that crash, and we like to call it a healing crisis, a crash, what led to that is a whole lot of variables. The one thing is that our environment is toxic. And the other thing is stress. Stress also creates toxicity. Mm-hmm. And then the third thing is, remember what I said earlier, undernutrition or malnutrition. All of those things leads to a broken down immune system. And then if you're a certain age, don't forget about altered hormones, which basically means, are you hormonally in balance? So that also leads to a broken down immune system. Because I have to tell you, a lot of people think that every single person that gets bit by a tick-borne, my son has been bitten. So many people on the island, not everyone will come down with Lyme, so you always have to remember why. Okay, so all of those things will lead to a mild sort of kind of immune dysregulation. Now, don't forget, at a certain age, some of us have what's called host of viruses. Some of us have CMV, some of us have MV, EBV, some of us have HV66. I mean, there's a lot of them, Dr. Pat. So not to get too complicated. And then some of us has what's called mild yeast syndrome, which basically means you may have a parasite or you may have some candida. You may have an overload of yeast buds in your body. So you see what I'm getting at? And so that leads to a broken down immune dysregulation, which causes a high level of cytokines, which creates a total inflammatory process in the body. Because I've seen people come to the retreat, they look and they are so inflamed, like the guy that just left about a month ago. He came in from Saudi Arabia. We now have people coming from out of the country. He came in from Saudi Arabia. He was so inflamed, Dr. Pat, that all you had to do was press on his thigh, and it was very, very painful.
Wow.
So that also leads to what's called a chronic, we call it chronic fatigue syndrome, which causes a whole host of other symptoms, which is all a broken down immune system, which possibly once you get bit, and that's what I'm leading to, now you get bit. What do you think's going to happen now with all of those things going on over the years, you get bit. Now you have what's called chronic Lyme, and you cannot get better, and no one medication is going to do it, because what I just gave you was a total body broken down immune system. So now people are probably saying, oh my goodness, that's a lot. Now, where do you start? Where do you go from here? Where you go from here, and why I wanted to do the show about this, you first have to feel better. And once you feel better, you can attack some of these other things. Like, you can't just zero in and just say, give me an antiviral, give me an anti-candida program, give me a parasite program, give me some antibiotics. What, are you going to kill yourself? So what you have to do first is say, I am going to start with what I put in my body each and every single day. And you get the energy, you start going on a healthy protocol. Now we say, okay, now you want to visit a doctor about your neurological symptoms. And then you may go down that road of getting the physical with your bones if you're having some rheumatoid problems. Because I know some of my Lyme patients have symptoms in every major organ in their body.
Oh, yeah.
They're really, really bad off. But I first had to get that inflammation down. I had to get what's called maximum nutrition in their bodies. And when I say, you know, a lot of times when I say maximum nutrition, people think it's very hard, Dr. Pat. It's not hard to put a lot of nutrition in your body. I'm going to tell you that I now have this food where if you just take two scoops of, let's say, hot rice or like this hot soup that we have or hot oats, we now have this company that put 43 essential nutrients in the food. So even starting out with one day at the retreat, you will have more nutrition in your body than the average person around the country get in a week.
You know, Dr. Roni, what you're saying is so true.
Yes.
It's so true. You know what it reminds me of? It reminds me of, you know, the metaphor, the idea of, you know, when you build a house, right? Mm-hmm. And everybody knows that the most important part of the house, you may think it's that master bedroom you're building. That is not it. The most important part of the house is the foundation. It's what happens in the foundation. And we have spent years breaking down our foundation. So the mistake that I think all of us make is what you just pointed to. If my foundation is not strong, and now I start to throw a lot of things at killing a lot of things in my body, it doesn't strengthen the foundation, you see. You know, it doesn't strengthen the foundation. It's an interesting idea, right? It's kind of like if the foundation of your house is really torn apart, you got some cracks in it, and then you start to pile on, you know, this 3,200 square foot infrastructure, it is not going to hold. And that's what I'm, you know, that's what I'm hearing you say, is what's happening is we're forgetting about what we need to do to build that foundation again. What do we need to do to build that foundation? Because right now, if it's not a pill, potion, and lotion that can make us well, or we think we're going to feel well from it, we're not really knowledgeable about what else can exist. And so what I hear you saying is, you know, do you want to be well? Do you want to feel vibrancy, vitality in your life? Do you want to be able to do the things that you always wanted to do? We're not even talking about the fact that some people can't even walk anymore.
I know.
That's what we're saying here.
And that's very sad to see some of these people like that, Dr. Pat. It really is. Mm-hmm. And sometimes because you see them so bad off, because that's what the retreat is about, we see them so bad off. You know, I don't know if I told you about the lady that came to me, because I've been treating Lyme for many, 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 many years, even before I knew it was Lyme. And that's called whole body protocols that we do at the retreat. But I'll never forget the time, you know, I've been doing a lot of Myers cocktails and I was doing glutathione. I was doing so much with her. And I remember her coming. She didn't have that diagnosis yet. And I remember she came to the retreat and she just had tears in her eyes and she was sobbing. And she was going, I got Lyme. And she was going, Lyme, you don't understand, I got Lyme. And I'm looking at her like, okay, you're going to be okay. She goes, no, I'm okay now. I now know I'm not going to die. I now know I'm not crazy. I now know why everyone was ignoring me. She says, because no one would tell me I had Lyme all these years. And now today is the happiest day of my life.
Wow.
Because now I could do something about it.
Wow.
So, you know, and these are the kind of people that I see. And there's so many myths out there, you know, about Lyme disease. One of the major myths, which really drives me crazy, is that all I need is to have a little bit of that antibiotic, doxycycline. You know, all I need, Dr. Roni, and I'll be fine. Just give me, I'll go to the doctors and I'm going to get like 21 days. How about 21 days instead of 7 days? And I'll be fine. So that's one of the biggest myths that's out there. And, you know, the other myth is that medication is the only treatment, which we now know. We've come a long way with Lyme. We now know that that's not the you're not going to get better with just that if you have chronic Lyme. And that the other Lyme is that if you didn't have that bull's eye, then you probably don't have Lyme. Well, we know that so many people today now never had the bull's eye, and they have chronic Lyme. So, you know, and I'll never forget the doctor, you know, that I met that had Lyme, and he had all of these cardiac symptoms. He almost died. He had palpitations. His heart was, like, failing on him. He literally almost died, and not one person ever considered taking a Lyme test, and he was a doctor.
Yeah. I mean, in the whole conversation, which I'm hoping we're going to bring an end to very soon here, is the whole conversation about the fact that here we are, and we're still giving people a 31, 32, 40-year-old test to diagnose them from Lyme disease. And in some states, Dr. Roni, from what I understand, you can't even get a Lyme test, even from the CDC. And I know that that's the truth. I mean, that is really part of a dilemma here. You know, I know somebody recently that was told by her cardiologist to get a Lyme test. And first of all, they never heard of any other Lyme test than the one that they were given. And most of them didn't know how to read it. Isn't that also part of the problem, that we have a scenario where there's only one test that will, quote, be approved? And by the way, that test doesn't work very well.
Yeah, that's another myth. Yeah. And then we've got, you know, people out there talking about which test is best. I mean, there's over what? Like, there's over like 9 different tests. And they're even got tests now for, like, this is crazy. They got tests just for babesiosis. They got a test just for Bartonella. They got tests for different types of the co-infections, and they're still talking about the ELISA test that doesn't work, and the Western blot test that doesn't work, and the IFA test that doesn't work, you know. And now I send the test to you know, the Igenix. Yeah. And you know, can I give that number out, because that's the,
yes, please,
that's the best test. And I send so many tests there that I pretty much know this by heart now. It's in, okay, now that I said it, I probably won't be able to remember. Okay, it's 1-800-832-3200. I give that number out so much because I learned how to read the Lyme test by, they taught me how to become really good at reading their tests. Yeah. So if you're going to a hospital or a clinic and they don't really have the best test, Igenix is the way. Now we finally got the hospital on Martha's Vineyard now, and this is just very, very, very recent, that they now are accepting the Igenix test.
Yay!
Sending it out. Yeah, well, they did it a few times. I hope they keep it up. So so we've come a long way on Martha's Vineyard as well.
Yeah, but that's because you're there, Roni. I mean, that's part of the conversation. See, you're right there in the middle of it. And, you know, the part of this is for people to know, how do I get well? Now, I want to just let folks know, go to Roni's website. I mean, I think it's important that people can find out about the retreat center, how to get a hold of you, all of the above, because this is really what this is about. 21 days out of your life is nothing if you know that you are going to get well. What's the best way for people to find out more about the retreat?
If they go to mbholisticretreat.com and just press that number, you put that number into, or there's a free consultation, I think, that's on Dr. Roni Holistic Health .com. But if you want to just book, just press that number in and someone will get right back to you. And then that... Yeah. And one of the things I want to tell people before we leave is that if you don't do anything else, if you can't come to the retreat right now, you have to do one thing. You have to call and let me tell you how to get on the food that have 43 essential nutrients in it.
Oh,
it will
good.
Make you feel better immediately.
Give out your number real quick. Give out your number, Dr. Roni.
My number is 774-208-2477. And when you call that number, you have to text me and say, tell me about the 43 essential nutrients. Because that food, maybe I was malnourished too. I don't know. I'm no exception. but I felt better immediately. In 2 to 3 days, I felt better. I felt like I can conquer the world.
I love it. I love you, Dr. Roni. Thank you so much.
Love you too, Pat.
Oh, my gosh. Everybody go to MV, Martha's Vineyard, MV, holisticretreat.com. Dr. Roni DeLuce, all of us here at Lyme Talk Radio, we wish you the best holiday ever, and don't ever give up hope. We'll see you next time.
Thanks for listening to Lyme Talk Radio with Dr. Pat Baccili, epic healing for an epic life. This inspiring show highlights leading-edge solutions, groundbreaking research, headline topics, and tools for holistic healing and wellness. This hit show is dedicated to raising awareness, promoting advocacy and prevention, and supporting initiatives for optimal health. Dr. Pat is passionate and focused on life-saving results reaching far beyond Lyme disease, providing a forum for powerful stories, heart-opening experiences, and hope-activated solutions. Dr. Pat will shine a light on the many shades of Lyme disease, fueled by a body-mind-spirit remedy. For more information, visit LymeTalkRadio.com and tune in next time.